Yeah, well, both those matches, those are both interesting matches you picked. AJ was, I wasn't really following jiu-jitsu at the time. That was when I first tried to compete again. I had no idea who he was, and this kid was just like, he was in an interview. He called in, started telling him that he tapped me a bunch of training. I never heard of the guy. I'm like, who is this douchebag? Well, as soon as I took the match, everyone kept being like, oh, this guy's a douchebag going against. And then sure enough, he calls, starts talking shit, and then I see him at the weigh-ins. And he starts talking crap to me there. He starts going, they had weird rules. If you didn't tap the guy, it was gonna be a draw. So he comes to me and he goes, I'm gonna get a draw with you. And he started bragging about that. He was trying to get a draw with me, like he was gonna try to stall. I'm like, what is wrong with this guy? So then I walked up and just dumped my soda on his head. And he sat there looking like an idiot. So that was before the match. But I'm like, this guy's been talking crap to me all week. So I was like, oh, screw this guy. He didn't. I think he was used to talking crap, nothing happening. So he was scared when I dumped soda on his head. He just kind of stood there like an idiot. But then after that, during the match, he was talking crap, smacking me. So I ended up, that was a video that went viral where I slapped him a few times. And that went, it went so viral, but because it was AJ, like everyone wanted to slap him. So it was one of those guys, everyone's like, oh God, thank God someone did it. And afterwards, AJ kind of grew on me a little bit. He ended up becoming friends with Nick Diaz.
Yeah,
so
right.
I see him occasionally now. We've hung out a couple times. He can still be a little obnoxious, but he's one of those guys that you're slowly like, all right, you learn to deal with him.
Sure. If your friend's cool, you can be cool, kind of a thing.
Yeah.